underestimated the number of people who might come to church this morning, so we run out of orders of service. So if anybody has one and sitting next to somebody else and they could possibly share, Karen will come. Oh, there you are. Just sort yourselves out. That's beautiful. Make sure everybody can see one. Right. Okay, there's another one here. One there for Andy. You're doing very well. Well, that's a nice problem to have. So, very warm welcome to our Advent, fourth Sunday of Advent service. And as is as what we've been doing over the last 3 weeks, we light our Advent candle. So, as always, I ask for a volunteer who's in a lighting mood. First of all, we come to God in penitence and in prayer, and we sing Kyrie Eleison. A candle for love. Love takes a little time. We light a candle for joy. And finally, we light a candle.
Thank you.
entered our world as the Prince of Peace. Fill us this Advent as we strive to become peacemakers with a deep and abiding peace. Help us to share hope, love, joy, and peace with all we encounter, especially those who need it most.
I'm a bit old for this song, but that's right.
My soul magnifies the Lord. All is ready, stable prepared, shepherds working, magi journeying, gifts are chosen. My soul magnifies the Lord. A city awaits, crowded and bustling, stars are shining, people expecting, a drama unfolding. My soul magnifies the Lord. The Lord is coming to save his people, Mary's obedience, Jesus' willingness, your gracious gift to us. My soul magnifies the Lord.
Let's stand to sing now of the Father's love.
Thank you.
Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace.
To read a poem which is by Carol Ann Duffy entitled Bethlehem. I get to look at the pictures. Sorry about that. You have to use your imagination. A mild dusk. The little town snaked on the edge between desert and farmland. Camel prints in the sand, like broken hearts, the call and response of sheep among dry shrub. To the west, the whispering prayer of olive groves, incense of rosemary, cedar, pine, votive on purpling air. Everyone there who had to be there. The lamps lit, all Bethlehem full, every cave stabled with beasts jostling for hay in the fusty gloom. Every room peopled and packed from rafter to floor, barley bread in the ovens baking, and a girl's hand at an open door, her blade halving a pomegranate, its blood on her pale palms. A voice from an alleyway chanting a psalm. The moon rose. The shepherds sprawled, shawled, a rough ring on sparse grass, passing a leather flask. From the town, a swelling human sound, cooking smells braiding the hour as lambs and fishes spat in the fires. 100 suppers, honey, fig, olive, grape, set before stonecutter, potter, tent maker, maid, nurse, farmer, child. Young wine in the old jars, yellow and cold. The inn bulged, travellers boozed, brawled, bragged, swapping their caravan tales, moneylenders biting their gold coins. Painted women dancing on tables, mules brayed outside in the stable, a youth in the courtyard strummed on a harp. The sweating innkeeper shouted and served, his wife counting the heads, then making up beds on the flat roof in the vine-covered yard. Above, bright news in the sky, arrived a star. The small hours, all living souls slept or half slept, the night fires smouldering low out in the scrub, the olive oil cooking in clay lamps, a goat herd snored in the straw between two goats. Silent night. A soft breeze from the desert, laying a dusting of sand on the dark road, blessing the homes. a donkey's slow, deliberate hooves on the stones. Afterwards, the witnesses spoke of a singing boy, an angel, walking the fields in the hour before dawn, winged in his own light. Of how the shepherds fled from the sight, lambs in their arms. And some swore on their lives, on their children's lives, that they saw an olive tree turning to pure gold, that the moon stooped low to gape at the world. What's certain? The time and place. Heard three crows from the cockerel. Seen the stable behind the inn. Present animals, goat herd, shepherds, innkeeper, wife. Then the small raw cry of a new life. And one wept at a miracle, another was hoping it might be so, others ran, daft, shouting to boast in the waking streets. And wise men swayed on camels out of the east.
Thank you. verse 39 to 55. In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, a child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed there would be fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, for he has looked with favour on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever."
Story is building, something is coming. We've reached the point where Mary humbly accepts the message of the angel. We've just just heard a carol, and it's not the only one which describes Mary as a rose. And she's sometimes called a mystical rose, the mystical rose. And that's a link to the very beautiful Song of Songs, the erotic love story in the Old Testament, in the Hebrew Bible. And in it, the bride in the poem says, "I am a rose of Sharon, a lily of the valley." And the groom replies, "As a lily among brambles, so is my love among maidens." And Christians have often seen the Song of Songs as an allegory about Christ and Mary and the church. St. Bridget wrote in a meditation on the mystical rose, "The Virgin may suitably be called a blooming rose. Just as the gentle rose is placed among thorns, so this gentle virgin was surrounded by sorrow." And this is the paradox in the figure of Mary. She is chosen and given prime place. She is Mother of God, the Christ bearer. She is a woman gifted with a child of immense grace, and yet she becomes a very tragic figure, first holding a babe in her arms, and then a crucified son. And Christian art portrays Mary both holding a babe in her arms and also holding a dead son as he's been taken from the cross, the image known as the Pieta, which means the pity. In the temple later in the story, Simeon says to Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." For me, that is the other contradiction in the story, the humble, submissive Mary, an image of Christian virtue, "Let it be to me according to your word," and the other Mary, who stands out and says, "He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted the humble and meek." Her humility, her submission is strength, it is not weakness. Her humility is being raised up, not being put down. The Advent journey moves us ever, ever closer to a birthing place. It takes us to a place of hope, love, joy, peace, to a place of strength, compassion, contentment, serenity. And this is the invitation that is open to us in the closing days of Advent as we move into Christmas itself. And yes, we know Mary's sorrow is not misplaced. There is every reason to focus on the thorns, prickly, sharp, and scarring. The lack of income, lack of homes, disruption in travel, the rapid environmental collapse, threats of war, dark times. And our mission in the church is to proclaim a gospel which does not hide these things, but that gives us strength, wisdom, and faith to withstand. Our faith is a blessing, and we should be open to receive it as Mary was open to receive. See amid the winter snow. Thank you.
sensing the sunlight, the tug of the ground, feeling and perceiving within and around. Good is the body, from cradle to grave. Good is the flesh that the Word has become. Good is the body, from cradle to grave, growing and aging, arousing and paired, happy in clothing or lovingly bared. Good is the pleasure of God in our flesh. Good is the flesh that the Word has become. Good is the pleasure of God in our flesh, longing in all, as in Jesus, to dwell. Glad of embracing and tasting and smell. Good is the body, for good and for God. Good is the flesh.
us today, I will end each verse with, Lord, meet us in the silence, and could you please respond with, and hear our prayer. So that's, Lord, meet us in the silence, and you say, Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious God, you call us together in unity, yet we live in a time of division, distrust, and despair. We pray for all nations, for those caught up in violence and conflict, and for those embroiled in political infighting. We pray for the honouring of human rights and for the relief of the oppressed. We pray that our leaders may rule with wisdom, equity and compassion, and that peace, justice and reconciliation may reign throughout the world. Lord, meet us in the silence and hear our prayer. Today we particularly pray for the residents of Sunda Strait in Indonesia who were hit by a tsunami this morning following the eruption of the Krakatau volcano. Lord, may you provide healing to the injured and comfort to those who mourn. We pray for wisdom and leadership among the disaster response teams and governmental authorities, as well as competence and strength amongst the medical workers. And in the weeks and months to come, may you help the communities rebuild their lives. Lord, meet us in the silence and hear our prayer. We lift up our own nation and pray that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. At a time of great political upheaval, confusion and cynicism, we ask, Lord, that you may guide the thoughts and desires of our leaders, especially for Theresa May. May you inspire them with truth and courage and open their eyes to the state of our nation and the cries of our people. Lord, we entrust Brexit to you. Pray that whatever happens, may we not lose sight of who we are called to be, children of God. Lord, meet us in the silence and hear our prayer. We pray for our local community and for all people in their daily life and work. We pray for the young and the elderly, for families and all who are alone, especially at Christmas time. We pray for those who are in need, for the sick, sorrowful and bereaved, and pray particularly for the many who are homeless. Lord, may you bring comfort, care and healing to all who call upon your name and help us as individuals and as a church to cherish human love and friendship and to enrich the lives of those around us. Lord, meet us in the silence and hear our prayer. Lastly, we pray for our church and congregation at Union Chapel. Thank you, Lord, for the success of last week's Carol by Candlelight service. We pray that the money raised will be of great benefit to the two charities, and that the message of love and giving may rest upon all our hearts this season. We pray for Vaughan and members of this church and ask for your protection upon them as they travel across the country and the globe. May you bless our time with friends and family. Help us draw near and not be blinded by consumerism, but set our hearts and minds on Jesus Christ who has given us life. Lord, meet us in the silence and hear our prayer. And together we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, ever and ever.
say the words in bold in the communion prayer. We won't say the Lord's Prayer again before we say it. And during the distribution, we hear the peace of Magnum Mass Mysterium rather than before the distribution. These are our gifts of bread and wine. We bring them to God. We come ready to receive the God who came at Christmas.
We come in the open hearts of God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift
them to the Lord. Let us give thanks.
We
praise you, powerful creator of the universe. In the beginning you were the Word, which commanded life into being. We adore you, our God, who kept the promise made to our ancestors in faith, the promise to redeem the earth and set us free. Worship you with the simplicity of a shepherd's conviction, with the wise of the ancient days who knelt before you and paid you homage.
Come, Lord Jesus, come. Draw again our hearts and restore our broken spirits.
In the company of generations of people present, in the sacredness of memory, in the martyrs and prophets of our day, with all of God's people in all the continents and throughout history, with angels and archangels, and all the company. Holy,
holy, holy,
Lord God of hosts, heaven
and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks for your coming. In the creation of the world, the beauty of shape and the miracle of matter, come to us. To Mary and Joseph, human parents in the heart of the universal story. To shepherds asleep on the hillside, disturbed by the celebration of the cosmos. Rebirth of creation. Through the wisdom of the East, kneeling at the door of the stable, gold, frankincense, and myrrh in hand, came to them and transforming these gifts to be for us the body and blood of Jesus Christ, who in the night of his arrest, betrayal, and torture, took bread, blessed it, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take it. This is my body, which is given. Do this in remembrance of me. Same way also he took a cup after supper, saying, this is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you drink it, do it in remembrance of me. As often as you eat the bread and drink the cup, proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. So in memory of all that Christ has done for us, through our faith, day by day, we bring our thanks to God. May we be united as your people, living your sacrifice and sharing in your death. We stand in your presence,
free of him, alive and strong.
We remember all who have died for you, especially those close to us.
May I remember.
We remember all in need. sing What Child Is This Who Lay to Rest. Service on Christmas Day here is at 10 o'clock in the morning, not 11, 10 o'clock. Next Sunday there won't be a service here, but the Sunday after it will be led by Graham White. Just one more thing to say.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe. To make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa is on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase for kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Shall we just say the grace? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.